If you get your news from TV news channels, mainstream newspapers, or even big news websites, you haven't heard this story. But it's possibly the biggest news story in India right now. Here's what happened. On May 25th, a non-profit journalism company called Cobrapost released almost 30 videos that revealed how immoral and corrupt most of India's mainstream news publications are. And this includes all the big names. Z, Times, New Indian Express, Hindustan Times, DNA, ABP News, and many more. Here's how they did it. Over many months, Cobrapost journalist Pushp Sharma pretended to be a man named Acharya Atal, a fake representative of Sangh, and under that identity, he set up meetings with the leaders in India's major news organizations. At the meetings, he offered them money for their promise to push the Hindutva agenda, promoting the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna worship, and more. He told the editors, managers, and leaders that the Sangh would eventually turn their attitude into votes in their favor. Pushp Sharma, as Acharya Atal, told the media houses that this was actually a push on behalf of the Sangh to prepare for the 2019 election. While he chatted with them, he secretly recorded them, and those were the videos that Cobrapost published last week. In them, you can see the Times Group CEO Vineet Jain, as well as the group's executive president Sanjeev Shah, state that they would accept a check of about 500 crores for adverts and events that subtly push the Hindutva agenda. You see Z's Synergy Chief Revenue Officer, Rajat Kumar, buy in and agree to create concepts, campaigns, and have further meetings. Scoopboop's founders say that they can't take a political stand, but are open to receiving money in return for pushing religious agenda. Cobrapost called this entire sting Operation 136 because 136 is the new rank of India on the World Press Freedom Index. Clearly, our press isn't free at all. See, they're trapped by a greed for profits, which corrupts the moral agenda needed to report news that's unbiased, truthful, and free of agenda. If you're a good news consumer, right about now, you're probably thinking, who's Cobrapost? Why should I consider them credible? How can I trust Pushp Sharma? Yeah, they're very credible. Here's a very quick background on them. Cobrapost was founded in 2003 by journalist Aniruddha Bahal, who is also the co-founder of Tehelka. They specialize in investigative journalism and sting operations. In a 2005 sting they conducted, they revealed that several members of the Indian Parliament take money in return for raising issues on the Parliament floor. After further investigation, that sting got 11 MPs expelled. So, they're legit. And even if you don't trust Cobrapost themselves, they've revealed all the footage of their conversations outright. You don't need to know much about them to come to the conclusion that most of India's mainstream media is willing to take money to push any agenda. See, it's one of the biggest stories out there right now, and the Indian media just doesn't seem to want to report about it. And there's a very simple reason. It reveals how corrupt all of them are. Not only did more than 24 organizations and companies accept the deal, many of the representatives even began ideating ways to execute the entire plan, offering to do reports, jingles, quizzes, events, and viral videos. In all the sting videos, the biggest player to have been exposed is Vineet Jain, managing director of the Bennett Coleman Group, the company that backs all of Times media companies. Times of India, Times Now, Mirror Now, and more. Cobrapost footage shows Vineet Jain widely accepting the transaction and even haggling on the specifics. For instance, he says he'll take a check and not cash. Oh, and then there's this. A few days after the Cobrapost thing went live, Times Group came up with a statement saying that they were actually doing a reverse sting to try and uncover who Pushp Sharma was actually working for, because he seemed like a dubious character. Right. Well, obviously, no one bought that. In fact, it's kind of become quite a joke. But what's not a joke is not only are mainstream channels and news organizations not covering the Cobrapost sting, they're in fact trying to figure out ways to bury the news and discredit Cobrapost. And in these attempts, they're sinking to new fucking lows. For example, on May 29th, Times Now ran a 2-hour debate about Tarun Tejpal's ongoing rape case, sensationalizing the story to try and make it the biggest story in the country and make people forget about the Cobrapost sting. Times Now aired footage of the entire assault repeatedly for 2 hours, which not only violates ethics and morals, but it's also illegal since the case is ongoing, not to mention it's an extreme violation of the survivor's right to privacy. 228A of the IPC, a provision used to protect the identity of victims of rape, prohibits the printing or publishing of anything in respect to a rape trial without the court's express permission to prevent the intrusion of their privacy. Just for everyone who doesn't have context, Tarun Tejpal was the editor-in-chief of Tehelka, and therefore he's broadly linked to the Cobrapost founders. The tapes were graphic in nature, sensitive, and super unethical. The Times Now anchor took the survivor's side for the entire 2 hours of it, but the fact that they chose to air that footage proves how little they care about the survivor's privacy. In their attempt to discredit the people who revealed them to be immoral, they went ahead and did something so much worse. That's the most egregious example of what media organizations are doing to cover up the Cobrapost thing. But it's not the only one. In short, all our biggest news organizations are willing to lie to us if someone pays them enough money. They're even okay with taking money to push political agenda in a year leading up to a general election. Worse still, they're okay with sinking to immoral, illegal, and unethical depths to distract us from how corrupt they actually are. Guess who the biggest victim of this broken news ecosystem is? It's you, and it's me. It's the citizens of India. A democracy is held up by 3 official pillars: the legislative, the judiciary, and the executive. And one very, very crucial 4th pillar: a free and objective media that holds governments accountable and tells the citizens what they need to know to make informed decisions about who leads us. Cobrapost revealed that that 4th pillar is up for sale, and our allegiance and our votes can be bought by the highest bidder. Hey guys, hope you liked the video, and if you did, please show some love and subscribe to our channel BuzzFeed India. So this is a different kind of video than you're used to seeing. I'm going to be doing this every Monday. What I do is I explain things, I talk about social and cultural issues. Is there anything that you want to discuss? Do you want to create any kind of dialogue about a particular thing? You want me to explain something? Do leave it in the comments, and we'll hopefully be able to make a whole video about it.